Hi guys, today we're gonna perform coliform or bacteriological experiment. So the objective of this experiment is to detect the amount of bacteria in 100 ml of water sample. So for this experiment, we have four different of water samples, different kind of water samples. We have tap water, we have wastewater, we have pond water, and we have river water. And the apparatus which we're gonna use is called quantitray, and we have collilid which has coliform on it. So first we're gonna start with placing this collilid into each container, and I'm gonna shake them until they dissolve. So take one collilid. Be careful when you're going to open. Make sure it's below here, and then you just flip it back to open. Take the container. Put the collilid inside your water sample. Make sure you just put everything inside. Close the vessel, container, and you begin to shake until it dissolves. So we're gonna do the same thing for all three water samples. Same, you're gonna open the container, take out one collilid, open. Place it inside. Close and then shake. So now I have placed all the collilid in all four containers which has different types of water sample. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna take the quantitray, this is called the quantitray. We're gonna pour the water sample inside this quantitray, and when we're gonna pour the sample, make sure there's no air bubbles trapped inside this squares. Make sure it's not trapped. So we have to pour the water sample very carefully and make sure there's no air bubbles. So I'll show you one how to do. So after you open the quantitray, pour the water sample carefully inside the tray. And then we observe for air bubbles. See, you can see air bubbles, right? We have to tap and make sure the air bubbles are not trapped. So now you can see that there's no air bubbles trapped inside. So now we have to do it for all other water samples, and then we have to now bring this to the incubator and incubate it for 24 hours. So for now, we are going to seal these quantitrays. So what we do, we take the quantity tray holder, we put the quantity tray inside, and then we just insert it inside the quantity tray sealer. So after it's been sealed, you can take it out. Be careful, the surface will be hot. So make sure it's not hot. And now you can remove the tray. So now you can see it's fully sealed. So as you can see, I have just repeated the sealing process for all other three quantity trays. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna place this quantity trays inside the incubator. So just place this quantity tray. And we're gonna incubate this quantity trays for 24 hours. So as you can see, we have completed all the steps. Step 1, we added the collylid. Step 2, we pour it inside the quantity tray. Step 3, we have filled sealed it. Step 5, we have sealed everything properly. And then until here, we have incubated the sample. So after we incubate the sample for 24 hours, the sample is going to look something like this. The quantity tray is going to look something like this. As you can see, we may have white boxes and yellow boxes. Okay, so how are we gonna do our result measurements? So once you have your quantity tray incubated for 24 hours, you take out your quantity tray from the incubator, and then you start to calculate how many yellow boxes are there in your quantity tray. Yellow boxes means it's positive for total coliform, which means the coliform is present. If it's clear, and then it's going to be negative for coliform and E. coli. So as you can see, we had four types of water sample: tap water, pond water, river water, and wastewater. For the tap water, we have to compare the number of boxes with another table, and for all other three types of water samples, we're gonna compare the number of boxes with the different tables. Okay, so this is the table that we're gonna use to get the result for our tap water. If let's say your quantity tray have 12 yellow boxes, then you're going to see your most preferable number, the MPN, for 12, and it's going to be 13.7. So this table is only applicable for tap water. Moving on, for the other types of water, which is the pond, river, and wastewater, we're going to compare our result using this table. So you can see over here, there are two columns, which is large well positive and small wells positive. What does this represent is that, as you can see the quantity tray just now, it had big wells and it had small wells at the bottom. So we're gonna calculate how many big wells are positive and how many small wells are positive, which is yellow in color. So let's say you have 10 large positive wells, and let's say you have 35 small positive wells. So 10 and 35, you can see the result is 15.8. So after this, what we're gonna do is we're gonna check for positive E. coli. How we do that is by using a fluorescent lamp. See, we're gonna shine this fluorescent light on top of our quantity and we're gonna see how many blue color wells are present, and we're gonna do the same as previous. We're gonna calculate how many wells are in blue color, which is positive for E. coli, and we're gonna repeat the same step for the tap water. We're gonna use this table, and for the other three types of water, we're gonna use this table. Thank you.